Hello students and viewers, I take this moment as the prestigious one to present this video session as a present to you all. This is K. Venkatesan from Department of Physics, Bharathasan Metric Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. Now I am going to introduce new topic, propagation of error, 11th standard physics, first unit. See here, propagation of error. Already we know that type of errors and how to propagate the error. The first, define error. Say, Raju, define errors. Yes, the error is defined as the uncertainty in a measurement is called error. Okay, see how to propagate the error. Let us consider to do one experiment. That time the same instrument or same experiment gives some different values. Okay, see, so at that time it propagates some type of errors. See here, the errors in the final results depends on, the first one is error in the individual measurement. The next one is the propagation of error produced on the nature of the mathematical operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, divisions, powers, everything. Okay, so this is the propagation of errors. The first, see, now in this class propagation of error discuss one by one. Okay, see, first one is error in the sum of two quantities. Error in the sum of two quantities. Let us consider here two quantities A and B. The absolute errors are del A and del B respectively. So here the measured value of A equal to A plus or minus del A. Here A is nothing but, what is the value? A. This is the one physical quantity. Here del A is nothing but absolute error of A. See here, the measured value of A is, this is the measured value, so absolute error del A. Here measured value of B is absolute error del B. Now error in the sum of two quantities, no. See here, the measured value of B equal to plus or minus del B, this first one, this is the second one. This is a two physical quantity and del A and del B are two absolute error. So here sum of two quantities, consider the sum of two quantities z equal to, see here, this is very important, z equal to a plus b. Z is nothing but sum of the quantities. A is the one of the physical quantity, b is another one physical quantity. Okay, see here, there the error del z in z is given by, z is given by, see, z plus or minus del z equal to, see, a value a plus or minus del a. The next one is plus b plus or minus del b. This is the sum of the two quantities. See, z is this nothing but sum of the two quantities a plus b. Already we know that a value a equal to a plus or minus del a and b value b equal to b plus or minus del b. Here summing, no, adding these two value. Okay, we'll get the answer. See, z plus or minus del z equal to adding two quantities a plus b plus or minus del a and del b. Del a plus del b. Okay, already we know that a plus b equal to z. A plus b equal to z. See, a plus b, replace the value, substituting the value z, we will get the answer. See, z plus or minus del z equal to, say, what is the value? A plus b, what is the value? Z, substituting the value z into or plus or minus del a plus del b, del a plus del b. Okay, see, very simple. here both side z z cancel, remaining del z equal to, say what is the value, remaining value del a plus del b, del a plus del b. These are final equations. Okay, easy, no? Yes. This is the error in the sum of two quantities, del z equal to del a plus del b. See, the next one is the error in the sum of two quantities. We conclude that, see, the maximum possible error in the two quantities is equal to sum of the absolute error. Sum of the absolute error. This equation we conclude that, see, del z equal to del a plus del b. This is the final equation. Okay. The maximum possible error in the sum of two quantities is equal to absolute error in the individual quantity, del a plus del b. Okay. In this statement, we conclude that del z equal to del a plus del b. See, next one. Basic formula, already we know that the sum of the two quantities del z equal to del a plus del b. So applying one problem, that formula we are applying one problem. Two resistance R1 is given 100 plus or minus 3 ohm, R2 equal to 150 plus or minus 2 ohm. Okay, or connected in series. What are the questions asking here? What is the equivalent resistance? What is the equivalent resistance? See here, already we know that formula. What is the formula? Here, what is the equivalent resistance? Sum of the value, no? So, resistance connected in series, we know that formula. Rs equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 dot 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 Rn. Resistance connected in parallel formula, we know that Rp equal to 1 by Rp equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 up to 1 by Rn. So, here asking, what is the equivalent resistance? What is the equivalent resistance? What is the formula for resistance connected in series? Yes, Rs equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay. See here, substituting this value, this formula, we apply here. Solution, equivalent resistance R equal to, equivalent resistance, this is the general formula, R equal to R1 plus R2. This is the general formula, resistance connected in series. So applying this two value, already the one value given, R1 equal to, see here, R1 equal to, what is the value R1? 100 plus or minus 3 ohm, okay. Here R2 equal to, what is the value R2 here? 150 plus or minus 2 ohm, okay. But you are asking R equal to R1 plus R2, sum of the two quantities. So formula, resistance connected in series Rs equal to R1 plus R2. This is the general expression, Rs equal to R1 plus R2. Applying these two values here, R1 is already, we know that R2 values even here given. So applying this value here, effective resistance Rs equal to R1 plus R2. R1 value here, 100 plus or minus 3 ohm. Okay. The next one is R2 value plus, R2 value 150 plus or minus 2. 150 plus or minus 2. Okay. Ohm. Already we know the formula. Sum of the two quantities. Take two quantities. 100 plus 150. Here Rs equal to 100 plus 150. This is the two quantity. Takes out remaining plus or minus. Adding these two value. Errors. Absolute error. 3 plus 2. Okay. See. Adding these two value. 100 plus 150. What is the value? 100 plus 150. Yes. 250. 250 plus or minus
5 absolute error ohm. This is the final equation.
Okay, 250 plus or minus 5. So you are given data R1 R2, will get the answer R is equal to 250 plus or minus 5 ohm. This is the equivalent resistance connected in series. Okay, we have attached PPT, YouTube link, study material and self assessment test for 25 marks in this description. Okay, thank you.